This is our third pair, the Canadians, Duhamel and Radford. Two-time world champions, six-time Canadian national champions who've been together for quite a while. This is their eighth season together. They won once this season on the home ice at Skate Canada to kick off the Grand Prix campaign. We're third recently at Skate America and also our Grand Prix final champions from 3 years ago. So they've had success at this event in the past.
Side triple Lutz, a slight 2 foot on Eric's landing, but still such high base value as you can see in the upper left-hand corner of the screen. Throw triple Lutz gets a little wild on the landing. You see that free hand touching down. That'll come off of the grade of execution. Some of the more difficult elements, but able to stay on their feet throughout.
One of the veteran pairs to make the Grand Prix final, 31 and 32 years of age, respectively, Duhamel and Radford, both from Quebec. And after coming off one of their most disappointing seasons in recent years, last year, they changed coaches over this past summer, saying now they feel refreshed, rejuvenated, and now the goal of landing one of those coveted spots on the podium at the Olympic Games in February. How about their chances?
Going into this season, you had to look at them as a middle-of-the-pack team. Even with two world titles under their belt, last season they were just underwhelming. They were making a lot of mistakes on the high-ticket items. But today, and this season, they've put it together a much better package. They started off the year at Skate Canada and put up a brilliant free program that just put them right back on the map. It entered them into the conversation of the world's elite, which was a spot that many thought that was behind them after those two world titles. They don't have the explosiveness. You can see on the triple twist, they don't have the same height that we'll see from the top Russian team or from the Chinese, but they have a lot of technical ability. The side-by-side triple Lutzes, they get a lot of points on those elements. They do the throw quad in the free program. When you have those big ticket items, you can make up for some of the power issues that they have, but they have a nice quality. This is a beautiful program, and you can see that edge starts to slip out from underneath Megan, and she fights to hang on, which is a very difficult thing with that much force coming out of the air. So it'll be very interesting to see how they stack up here at the Grand Prix Final. We've seen them put up some huge scores this season. If they can continue that type of momentum through this weekend, they could easily enter themselves right back into that podium conversation at the Olympic Games.
What's interesting to note is they have won each of the last three times they have competed in Japan at a Grand Prix event. This is the first time that Nagoya, Japan has hosted a Grand Prix final. They have had, obviously, a lot of success in this country. And now, as the third of three pairs to skate in the short program, their scores 72-18, second place at the moment.
The score for Omega Yuhamo and Eric Rockford is 72.18, which brings in third place.
So, we are halfway through.